Hello students, in today's class we will be studying about the nutritional classification of microbes, or in other words we will be studying about based on nutrients how the microorganisms are classified. In the previous class we had studied about the different nutritional requirements of microorganisms, that is we had classified the nutrients based on the different types of nutrients that is required by the microorganisms. Now here, based on those nutrients we are going to classify the microorganisms. So here we are classifying the microorganisms based on nutrition, so the nutritional classification of microbes. So what are these nutrients? As we had studied, they are basically substances that the organisms taken from natural sources, which is used in the biosynthesis, and when they are using this for metabolic activities during the biosynthesis, energy is released. And this energy, why is it required? It is required for various activities for the microbial growth. Now there are different parameters based on which the microorganisms can be classified. It's not that all the microorganisms require all the nutrients that we had studied in the previous class. There are the organisms, some group of organisms are specific to one kind of nutrients. So based on the category of nutrients or based on the parameters, so first we have to look into the parameters. So what are the parameters that we are considering for classification of microorganisms for nutrition is carbon source, energy source and electron source. So the three parameters that we can classify the microorganisms based on nutrition is the first parameter is carbon source, the next is energy source and the electron source. So if the carbon source, based on carbon source, we can classify the microorganisms into two categories, that is autotrophs and heterotrophs. So if they are taking carbon source can be of two types, that is the organisms can be autotrophs and heterotrophs, autotrophic and heterotrophic organisms. Now, what are autotrophs? Autotrophs are those organisms who use carbon dioxide as the source of carbon. And what are heterotrophs? Heterotrophs are those organisms who use sugars or carbohydrates as the source of carbon. So autotrophs are the one who use carbon dioxide as a source of carbon, and heterotrophs are those organisms who use sugars or carbohydrates as a source of carbon. The next criteria that we had seen, or parameter that we had seen, is energy source. So based on energy source, there are two kinds of organisms, phototrophs and chemotrophs. Now what do you mean by phototrophs? From the name itself, we can understand photo means light. So those organisms who use light as the source of energy, they are called as phototrophs. And chemotrophs are those organisms who use chemicals as the source of energy. So, and based on energy source, we can classify them as phototrophs and chemotrophs. Moving on to the next parameter that we had studied is based on electron source. So based on electron source, we can classify or categorize the two types of organisms, that is organotrophs and lithotrophs. Lithotrophs are those organisms who use inorganic substances as the source of electron, like sodium chloride, H2O, these are the ammonia, these are the ones who which can be used. Okay, so based on electron source, lithotrophs are those organisms who use inorganic substances as the source of electron. And organotrophs are those organisms, from the name itself we can understand that these organisms use organic substances as the source of electron. Okay, so proteins, example protein. So these are the different based on electron source, lithotrophs and organotrophs. Organotrophs are those who use organic substances as a source of electron, and lithotrophs are the ones who use inorganic substances as a source of electrons. Okay, now we had seen the parameters. Now the three parameters, and we had seen lithotrophs, organotrophs. Now the organisms are not restricted only to carbon source, only to energy source, and only to electron source. I mean to say, there is a combination of all the three parameters. Every organism have a they require carbon also, they require energy also, and they require electron also. So how, based on all the three parameters, what is the actual, what is the classification of the microorganisms? Now here, look at this picture. I have just combined all the three things based on carbon, autotrophs and heterotrophs, based on energy, phototrophs and chemotrophs, based on electron, lithotrophs and organotrophs. Now, based on all these parameters, now the classification starts. Now, the first kind of classification is photolithoautotrophs. The first classification is photolithoautotrophs. Now here you can see here photolithoautotrophs. Now what are these photolithoautotrophs? We have already studied here. They use light as a source of energy, electron, inorganic substance source of electron, and carbon dioxide as a source of carbon. Now they can also be called as photoautotrophs. Now even if you call them as photoautotrophs, it is understood they are called as photolithoautotrophs. Example here is algae. Moving on to the second classification is photoorganoheterotrophs. The second classification, photoorganoheterotrophs. So here you can see they use light as the source of energy, organic substances as a source of electron, sugar as a source of carbon. Okay, so photoorganoheterotrophs. Now they can also be called as photoheterotrophs. Example for this is purple non-sulfur bacteria. Example is purple non-sulfur bacteria. Okay, so what could be the next kind of classification? The next classification is chemolithoautotrophs. That is chemolithoautotrophs. So these use chemicals as a source of energy, inorganic substances as a source of electrons, and carbon dioxide as a source of carbon. So they are called as chemolithoautotrophs. Now they are also called as chemoautotrophs. If we call them as chemoautotrophs, it is understood it is chemolithoautotrophs. Example is sulfur reducing bacteria. Moving on to the next kind of classification is chemoorganoheterotrophs. The next kind of classification is chemoorganoheterotrophs. So it is, these organisms use chemicals as a source of energy, electrons as a source of, organic substances as a source of electrons, and they use sugar for their carbon source. So they are called as chemoorganoheterotrophs. They can also be called as chemoheterotrophs. It is the same thing. And the example for this is protozoa. So these are the four types of classifications of the organisms based on the nutrients, based on the requirement of nutrients. So the four classifications are photolithoautotrophs or photoautotrophs, photoorganoheterotrophs or photoheterotrophs, chemolithoautotrophs or chemoautotrophs, chemoorganoheterotrophs or chemoheterotrophs. So these are the classification, students. Remember, these we are classifying organisms based on nutrition. The previous class we had classified nutrients of the different organisms. Thank you.